not to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedoms away.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. And here we are, the end of America, and probably the day that I'm the most disgusted that I've been in I don't know how long. Thanks to 2012, the Awakening WordPress blog for their updates, feeding the homeless band in cities all across America. I did try to verify this photo, which I wasn't able to do. I didn't spend a lot of time on it, but you can see it's nyc.gov/parks, and to me this looks like a real sign. The Merry Christmas one may be photoshopped in. That looks like it's not supposed to be there, but this one looks like a real sign to me. Zip ties and all that. And maybe it's fake. I don't know. But I know that because of this update, which, you know, there's no links in here, but if you care, then you do a little Google search. So, this is what I found, and I'm disgusted. First of all, I will not fucking comply. You cocksuckers. You will not. You will not. I don't care what you voted for, who you voted for. I'm telling you, I will not comply. And I'm going to get to the point that I don't care if you have a badge or authority by some other individual who got authority from some other individual who got authority from some other individual who was voted in by a bunch of fucking sheep that really don't care, or the self-centered bastards, and pass laws to restrict my life. You put your hands on me, I'm going to return fire. That's it. I've had enough. Especially when it comes to issues like this, arresting people, threatening with arrest to feed them. All over this country. All over. I don't know if I'm even... I'm going to read this. This is, one Saturday morning, August 24th, Love Wind showed up at Moore Square at 9 a.m., just like we have done virtually every Saturday and Sunday for the last 6 years. We provide, without cost or obligation, hot coffee and a breakfast sandwich to anyone who wants one. We keep this promise to our community in cooperation with 5 different large suburban churches that help us with manpower and funding. On that morning, 3 officers from Raleigh Police Department prevented us from doing our work. For the first time ever, an officer said quite bluntly that if we attempted to distribute food, we would be arrested. Our partnering church brought 100 sausage biscuits and large amounts of coffee. We asked the officers permission to disperse the biscuits to the 70 people who had lined up waiting to eat. They said no. I had to face those that were waiting and tell them I could not feed them or I would be arrested. I would have thrown the box to them and said, put the fucking bracelets on, tough guy. Raleigh police, I wish I could hack. I wish I knew who you were, you 3 officers, you fucks. Probably just before you got out of the car, you jammed a sausage muffin down your face. Huh? Can't feed the homeless in this country. Really? USA Today listing out all the cities. More than 50 cities. No camping, no food sharing laws. And the camping I can understand because of the waste, no toiletries, the destruction to the land in public places. I can understand that. I can reason that out inside the city. I can understand that. But again, I can't understand it fully because you haven't done anything to help these homeless people. And I know some of you see this video, fuck them. They're drunks, they're drug addicts. Well, let me tell you, I've been homeless with 3 kids and I was never one of those. I wasn't a drunk or I wasn't a drug addict. And if it wasn't for the kindness of somebody else, there were a few days my kids wouldn't have eaten. Even now, we live with somebody else and I just lost my job Monday. It's going to be tough. May have to call on somebody to help feed these kids for a little while. And you're going to tell me that's illegal. United States? Really? united? Define the word. I thought that meant all together, connected, mutual bond, mutual respect. What in the fuck have you people allowed to happen to this country? And I'm guilty too. Please, don't think I'm attacking you, because I'm guilty. Because all growing up, I had that sixth sense that it was all a lie. I wouldn't take part in any of it. Go ahead, you researchers. I've never voted. Not once. No. Didn't even vote for king and queen at the prom, because I thought that was just ignorant, too. Never voted, nor will I ever. The only thing I will vote for is all of us standing together and shutting down this government. It is an illegal, corrupt, terroristic regime that is not only going out of its way to kill people, it's making sure that they just die on their own. It's another post I wanted to show you. I'll link you to all this stuff. Okay, so I've told you you're not allowed to feed the people. And I want to show you that although the government, they're going to give you these reasons, oh, we can't, like in New York, I think it was, they can't verify the fat and salt content, so you can't feed anybody. You can't give away a cup of water some places because you can't verify the salt content, some ignorant thing. I don't know. And then we see headlines like this. Your same government allows this. This is today's headlines. GMOs. That's what they're feeding you. Deformities, birth defects, and piglets. Ex-Monsanto employee involved in discrediting study linking GMOs to cancer. In cooking with Splenda found to release cancer-causing dioxins in food. Is this why we can't feed anybody? Because the government allowed poison to be put into the food, and now we don't know if the food is safe for those homeless people, so we can't give it to them. I know, it doesn't make sense. That can't be it. Then explain it to me. Give me a reason that's valid. Don't tell me that, you know, the food could be spoiled. Because I don't think that homeless person really cares. I think they're willing to take that chance, and that's their right to do so. I know. There's all kinds of reasons, right? You don't want to see them gathering near you. They're dirty. Look at their hair. My God, won't he put some shoes on? I can't be a part of any of it. I really can't. Quite honestly, I'll tell you all that for the last year, I've really been contemplating shutting down this YouTube channel, my website, my Facebook, my Twitter, just moving out into the woods. Because I fought. And I know, I haven't had as much time in as many of you, so I'm no hero. But for the last, I don't know, as I grew with it, the last 3 to 5 years, giving some portion of every one of my days to wake some people up in some fashion. I've had many days that it went end day after day of not doing anything but just this. One, because I didn't have any work, and two, because there were things going on that you needed to know about and I wanted you to be informed. And I thought that if I informed you, you would make a change. The only change that's happening is it's going from bad to worse. But we're still not doing anything. Notice I said we. I do take responsibility. No, I don't think that if I voted any of those times, anything would have been different. I think that it was a deception from the beginning. We came, we kicked their ass, we organized individual states where we could all group within a certain place of like minds and live free in unison with each other, and they knew that was the perfect situation. Just like they knew the Indians was the perfect situation. Every tribe taking care of itself, living on what was provided, acting in respect of each other. Although we may do things differently and think differently, we won't violate each other inside of the other's space. They couldn't have that. They couldn't have United States just hanging out together. No, they had to pull them all together into one place again. It was lost the day it was gained. We have to do the same thing. We have to go back a couple hundred years, people, or it's not going to work. You've been doing this for how long? You're here now. I said this yesterday, repetition of the same behavior, expecting a different result, is the definition of insanity. Oh, well, we do have a different result now, huh? Because every time you vote, more laws are put in place. Laws like this, that you can't feed the human next to you when he has no food. Welcome to America. Now we kill you.
And you've got to put your body upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers, upon all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop. And you've got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you...